As you see, my presentation entitled Azerbaijan's Rising Economic Power. This is the content of my presentation. And this is the first slide of my presentation, Human Development versus IDP's share. Azerbaijan combines two diametrically opposed approaches, such as radicalism and gradualism, based on pragmatism, optimal sequencing of reform measures. And because radicalism might lead to the economic big bang, while gradualism might slow down the transition process. And that's why in the context of gradualism versus radicalism, Azerbaijan has chosen own way pragmatic economic policy. Azerbaijan has came to the top by three indicators. First of all, unprecedented economic growth. The second one, the high speed of the improvement of Human Development Index. And the last one, the high share of IDPs and refugees in our population. We plot the data here, human development versus IDPs share. And we assign IDPs share in population to the horizontal axis and human development index to the vertical axis. And Cartesian coordinates enable us to visualize relationship between IDPs share and human development. And logically, high IDPs share corresponds to low human development. But in case of Azerbaijan, high IDPs share corresponds to high human development. And I have deliberately put the results of regression with very low statistical significance, because there might not be any positive correlation or any correlation between IDPs share and human development. Having around 1 million refugees and IDPs, Azerbaijan has managed to attain unbelievable economic growth and human development, high human development as well. The second slide, competitiveness versus hydrocarbon resources. We see that hydrocarbon resources potential in Azerbaijan is much lower than other neighboring countries such as Iran, Kazakhstan, and Russia. Of course, we cannot, if we take into account per capita oil and gas deposits, we cannot pretend to be a cold equivalent of Qatar, because we left behind about 50 times in these terms. But we are comparable with Kazakhstan and Russia and Iran. Also, we have less per capita oil and gas deposits. Azerbaijan outperforms all neighboring resource-rich countries such as Iran, Kazakhstan, and Russia. On the other hand, Azerbaijan has progressed in savings of hydrocarbon resources as a share of GDP. The assets of oil fund of Azerbaijan Republic comprise 43.9% of GDP in 2012, while Iranian oil stabilization fund consists of only 1.1% of GDP. Or let's say Kazakhstan National Fund consists of about 30%, or Russian West Fund about 27% of GDP. And it shows that Azerbaijan is more effective in this case. But I would like to localize our comparison. And this slide I call two Bilasuars. The city of Azerbaijan populated Bilasuar was divided between Iran and Azerbaijan. And in order to compare two Bilasuars, I would like to take into account, first of all, average income level of households. The average income level of households in rural areas was $7,500 in Iran and $10,400 in Azerbaijan. So in terms of average household level, we outperform, our Azerbaijani Bilasuar outperform Iranian Bilasuar, because household income in Iranian Bilasuar is less than three-fourths than that of Azerbaijanian Bilasuar. In contrast, Iranian Bilasuar, Azerbaijanian Bilasuar have more developed, viable, and competitive infrastructure. And you can Google a map and find out the difference between city appearance as well. And to this end, I would like to ask question, rhetorical question on Acemoğlu or Robinson's in Why Nations Fail. How could the halves of what is essentially the same city be so different? There's no difference in nationality, geography, or let's take climate. Even diseases are same. But there are only one obvious and simple answer. Institutions in Azerbaijan are more conducive to economic development and social development as well than those of Iran. And the main reason, the border that defines two halves. The next slide is about macroeconomic perspective. And I would like, based on monetary and fiscal policy, just explain our situation. First of all, about monetary policy. The profit of our bank sector increased by 7 times during last 10 years, and Azerbaijan now is gradually shifting from gradually shifting toward more flexible exchange rate that enables more independent monetary policy and additional tools to absorb shocks as well as external shocks. As Azerbaijan diversifies its export and integrates with international monetary, international financial institutions, it needs markets, it needs more independent monetary policy. And that's why this strategy will pave way for the introducing inflation targeting, which is an anchor for independent monetary policy. International Monetary Fund indicated that continuing capitalization and consolidation process in banking sector are an opportunity to make more stable, competitive banking sector in Azerbaijan. A little bit about fiscal policy. Our state budget increased by 19 times during the last 10 years. And now Azerbaijan is gradually shifting from pro-cyclical fiscal policy to counter-cyclical fiscal policy. For example, after global crisis between 2009 and 2015, 2012, the GDP growth of our non-oil sector was 17.3%, while the current expenses from state budget increased only 14.4%. And outperforming of our non-oil GDP growth over current expenses from state budget fuels fiscal space, which is very important for fiscal sustainability and macro sustainability as well. A large number of developing nations have pro-cyclical fiscal policy because of, first of all, imperfections in international financial markets. And the second reason is related to political economy, which is based on the idea that good times increase. And researchers from the National Bureau of Economic Research have identified a significant impact of expansion of fiscal policy on GDP growth in developing nations. And to this end, rationalizing of Azerbaijani fiscal policy, public investment, will be the way to consolidate the non-oil fiscal position in Azerbaijan. To this end, Azerbaijan can draw lessons from South Korean experience. And like other northeast neighbors, Asian neighbors, South Korea government didn't hesitate to take to use public enterprise as a direct and interventionist tool to forward national resources toward investment. And from capital budgeting point of view, of course, this is very important for Azerbaijan because our fiscal expansion policy creates more public assets and then we can operate and then to transfer to private sector as well. And the next slide is about inclusive growth. Azerbaijan's sharply increasing oil revenues made it possible to increase wage and social transfers as well. And according to World Bank estimations, in the absence of social transfers, the poverty rate would have been around 25% in Azerbaijan. But as you know, Azerbaijan decreased poverty rate from 49% in 2001 to 6% in 2012. And I have own estimations. In the absence of compulsory state budget expenditures on defense, Azerbaijani government would be able to eradicate poverty, not only in Azerbaijan, but also in hypothetically, of course, in Armenia as well. This is a cost of aggression, and this is a cost of occupation of Azerbaijani territories for whole region, including Armenia as well. So Azerbaijan provides inclusive growth policy, which is attributable to productivity and attributable to the poverty reduction as well. The main target of human development in Azerbaijan to extend people's choice, and Azerbaijan has achieved a significant, the most significant advance in human development index between 2005 and 2012. And Azerbaijan progressed from the group of countries with medium human development to the group of countries with high human development in 2011. And Azerbaijan left behind the average world growth rate of human development index between 2000 and 2011 two times, and entered to the top planet's 15 countries in terms of human development improvement. But not all rapidly growing countries achieve human development index improvement, such as well-turned in Azerbaijan. For example, China and Brazil stay far behind Azerbaijan to achieve human development index improvement. And this is one more evidence how well we convert our oil and gas windfall to the development of our nations. As a global leader, Azerbaijan defined one more very important record in human development index. This is a Gini coefficient, inequality coefficient. Gini coefficient was the lowest level between 2000 and 2011 in Azerbaijan. And this shows that the contribution of incomes among individuals is the most fair in Azerbaijan in that times. And in this sense, Azerbaijan case proves the accuracy of the notion that lowering inequality causes human development index to increase. And the last slide is about smiling curve economics. Stan Shi, the business tycoon from Taiwan, put forward the idea of smiling curves. As per this concept, in product life cycle, the stage such as product conceptualization, research and development, designing, distribution, marketing, sales, after sales services add own value to the product. And that's why both sides of smiling curve command higher additional value to the product than the middle side of smiling curve. If we put this phenomenon in graph, the resulting curve will appear like smile. And that's why we call this approach smiling curve. Let me just applicate smiling curve approach in Azerbaijani economy. Launching Azerbaijani-owned satellite is a brilliant example of smiling curve in Azerbaijan. For example, Azerbaijan ordered this satellite to Orbital Science Corporation, Dallas, Virginia-based U.S. company, which designed and built this satellite under the contract $205 million. Then this satellite was carried into orbit by Iron Space spacecraft in French Guiana. And as a result, our income from this satellite, which will provide telecommunication services for Azerbaijan, Central Asia, Eastern Europe, and North Africa, will be about $405 million. And this shows that Azerbaijan's gross profit margin will be nearly 40%, while manufacturer, designer, launcher, and insurance of this satellite have gross margin profit a few percent of their product or service. And this shows that the value goes to where money and idea are. And the, and of course, let's take just our production sharing agreements. 85% of our oil revenue from the contract of century go to Azerbaijani side, while our transnational companies gain only 15% of oil production in Azerbaijan. When we analyze the structure of import, we see that the lion's share belongs to investment goods, machines, technologies, etc., etc. And that's why we try to be on the higher levels of smiling curve in order to continue our smiling.